So what is keratoconus? Keratoconus is a progressive eye disease of the cornea, the front window to the eye, that often leads to blurry and distorted eyesight. Keratoconus can even become so severe that it not just causes blurred vision, but can require a corneal transplant if not caught early. So in this video, we are going to explain keratoconus, going over the symptoms, the causes, how it can be diagnosed, and then ultimately the best steps for keratoconus treatment. Let's take a look. Hello and welcome. This is Dr. Allen here from the Dr. Eye Health Show, and welcome to our part one of our video series all about keratoconus. The whole point of this video series is to really help people learn about keratoconus, whether you yourself have been diagnosed with this, or maybe a friend or a family member has been diagnosed with this condition, so we can better explain what's going on, as well as how your doctor can help you through the process of getting it treated to stop the progression of this condition, as well as help you see better. So if this is your first time to the channel, definitely hit the subscribe button and look at the top of the video description for a link to the complete series all about keratoconus. That way you won't miss any of the critical videos and understanding how this disease progresses and then ultimately how we treat it and get you seeing better. Now let's talk about keratoconus. So what is keratoconus? Keratoconus is again a disease of the cornea, the front window to the eye. Normally the cornea is round, smooth, and has a regular surface. But for somebody with keratoconus, the cornea progressively thins over time. And with this thinning, the cornea begins to protrude outward from the eye, creating the shape of a cone. It even has kind of a tip-like appearance. In fact, in advanced cases of keratoconus, we can even have people look down and you can see the pointed edge of the cornea in their eyelid, something that we call Munson's sign. You can even see in this magnified view of a cornea where it begins to protrude and you can even see its thinning. Now again, keratoconus is a progressive condition, meaning it often gets worse and worse over time. And that leads to extreme thinning of the cornea and an irregular surface. And with this progression, people often end up with irregular astigmatism and scarring of the cornea, which can cause visual problems. So let's talk about the symptoms. The symptoms of keratoconus that people usually experience include blurry vision and shadowing of letters. That blurry vision and shadowing that people experience comes from the irregular astigmatism that's caused by the shape of the cone of the eye. Imagine looking through a lens that causes your vision to look like this. Makes it very difficult to see. Light just doesn't pass through an irregular surface like this, and that causes not only blurred vision, but again that shadowing around letters and objects. Now, because of the progressive nature of keratoconus, an early tip-off to both patients and doctors is that if somebody's glasses prescription or their contact lens prescription continues to progress and gets worse and worse over time, usually in the matter of only a few weeks to months. And if keratoconus is left to progress, it often leads to scarring of the cornea, which causes increased amounts of glare and a blurred vision, often so bad that we can't even correct it with glasses and contact lenses. And in extreme conditions of keratoconus, the cornea can become so thin that it even becomes painful. So it's super important that we are able to catch keratoconus early and begin treatment so we can slow it down and hopefully stop its progression. And again, the earlier we catch it, the better. So what causes keratoconus? The causes of keratoconus are complex and not fully understood at this time, but is believed to be caused by an enzymatic breakdown of the collagen structures within the cornea. A strong characteristic of people who develop keratoconus is a history of eye rubbing. Whether they're rubbing their eyes from eye allergies or just eye irritation, the rubbing of the eye is strongly associated with both the development and the progression of keratoconus. So a good tip for everybody, whether you have keratoconus or not, is to not rub the eyes. I know it feels good momentarily, but it usually just makes things worse. Instead, try to use lubricating eye drops or maybe a cold compress to help with your symptoms. Now, in addition to all of this, keratoconus has been found to have a genetic component to it, so much so that we now have a genetic test that we can order and run here in the clinic, even through just something as simple as a cheek swab. And this genetic test is super important, especially for families, as somebody who has keratoconus maybe will pass on that gene to their children. And again, if we're able to test people and catch it earlier, the better. So how do we diagnose keratoconus? Well, the diagnosis of keratoconus is something that is usually done through a comprehensive eye exam, but we often have special tools and technologies that help us make this diagnosis easier. Now, I do want to show you a couple of different tools that you may see in an eye clinic that help us make this diagnosis, because I think it's going to be fun to, for one, you to know what to expect when having this evaluation, but also just to see what your doctor's looking at to help make this diagnosis. The first instrument you may see is something called a corneal topographer. This often has these circular rings on it that we call a placebo disc. And by taking a picture of the surface of your eye with this instrument, we can more easily detect the subtle changes of the cone that is developing on the surface of the eye. The second instrument you may see is very similar, but that one we call a corneal tomographer. And that is kind of like getting many B-scan ultrasounds of the eye, and is really helpful because we can see how thin the cornea is at different locations, especially on the back surface of the cornea, which is in fact the first sign of keratoconus that we can detect. And we can detect that well before we start to see any sort of a cone shaping on the surface of the eye. And the third test that your doctor may order is something called a corneal pachymetry, which helps us measure and quantify the thickness of that cornea as it progressively thins over time. So don't be surprised if your doctor ever orders one or all of these tests, because it will help them determine if you have this condition and if it's something that is progressing. So now let's talk about keratoconus treatment. But first, if you're finding this video valuable, drop us a comment in the comment section below, because I think that'll be a good place just to connect with other people who may be going through this eye condition. Now, treatment for keratoconus is really broken down into two steps. First is surgical treatment, and the second is vision correction. Now, after the diagnosis, the first step in keratoconus treatment is that of trying to slow down or halt the progression. And this is achieved through something called corneal collagen cross-linking. And this is the topic of our next video in this series, which we'll go really in detail about. So that's going to be really important for you to watch if you were just diagnosed with this. But with corneal cross-linking, we can hopefully stop the progression of keratoconus and hopefully prevent somebody from ever needing a corneal transplant in their lifetime. Now, an important thing to know is that corneal collagen cross-linking is aimed to slow down and stop the progression of keratoconus, but doesn't improve vision. So in the eye clinic at this time, we focus on glasses and specialty contact lenses to help people see better. Now, regular eyeglasses do often help people with keratoconus, but they rarely get people to see their best. In fact, most people with keratoconus, I would say, rarely see 20/20 with glasses alone. Oftentimes, because glasses don't achieve the best vision, doctors often fit specialty contact lenses for people to help them see even sharper. This can be done with rigid gas permeable or RGP contact lenses. It can be done with hybrid contact lenses, which are hard lenses that have a soft lens around it, or even using a piggyback technique where they have a soft lens on the eye and then another hard lens on top of that one. However, many cornea and contact lens specialists now prefer fitting of scleral contact lenses. Scleral contact lenses are hard and oversized contact lenses that touch on the white part of the eye called the sclera. And this creates kind of a bowl effect where it vaults over the cone of keratoconus. And with these large contact lenses, they can neutralize a lot of the distortions and irregularity that cause blurred vision, which can often be really amazing to see people see so sharply after living their life with blurred vision from keratoconus. But the fitting process, including the insertion and removal of scleral lenses, is like a whole process in its own. So stay tuned to future videos in this series where we go over what scleral lenses are, the fitting process, and again, helping you learn how to put them in, take them out. But again, at this time, the most important step after the diagnosis of keratoconus is getting set up for corneal collagen cross-linking, because again, that's going to slow down and hopefully stop the progression. To learn more about that whole step and see that next video in our series, go ahead and click or tap the screen up over here to the side, or check out the link for our whole video playlist in the description below. Otherwise, thank you so much for watching, and I hope this video helps you out in some way. Again, this is Dr. Allen. Keep an eye on it, and we'll talk to you soon.